The power of repeatable collections. So as you can see, I don't have a lot of coins, but the repeatable stadium collection I did last night at first, and then I started doing it today again. I've done it probably 3 or 4 times, and you get badge packs out of these. Last night I got a gold, and so I only had like 4,000 coins. I'm getting ready to take off and not play for a day or two, so I was like, well, let's farm some, you know, stadiums. You can normally get them for either 100 coins each or like 350, 500 at the most for the ones that are kind of rare. But you can stack them up, do it over and over, and then you can see the benefit at the end of this video of what really happened. So, you know, you find one for cheap. This one is 350, so I picked it up, you know, no big deal. 350 is not that much in retrospect, you know, as far as what it takes to, as far as coins. So even if, you know, there were 100 coins each on all of them, you know, there I did my Raider Stadium. You can see I get the badge pack, and then we come back and open the badge pack, and sure enough, sometimes you get lucky. A lot of times you'll just get bronze badges, sometimes you'll get silvers, but in this particular case, wait for it, here we go. Bronze Elite. Yes, that's an elite badge in a stadium pack. It can happen. Confirmed. That is awesome. That is worth a ton of coins. If you go check the price, I don't know what it is right now, but it's a great tip for guys starting out with MUT. Just keep farming it. Start out with like 5,000-6,000 coins. Just keep buying the stadiums. Use the ones you have in your binder. Build them up. Keep getting these badges, keep stacking them up. You can upgrade them to the higher badges, go do the flashback collections, and you're off and running. So anyway, guys, that's my tip for the day for Madden 15 launch day, and I will talk to you later. Peace.